started to talk about the A word, abortion. And there's the new debate on Planned Parenthood and the alleged selling of aborted baby fetuses for profit and stem cell research. Positions on the defunding of Planned Parenthood are deeply polarized, concentrating on the legality and legitimacy of the accusations against Planned Parenthood. There's an ongoing argument that comes from many different angles, and I will be focusing on the three main topics, which are the authenticity of the videos released by the Center for Medical Progress, also known as the CMP, the lawfulness of selling these aborted fetuses, and the final question of should abortion be legal or not. In mid-July, it seemed that the world kind of split into two groups, and that was the Planned Parenthood haters, which are basically pro-life supporters, and they just want abortion cut out from everywhere. They think that it should be illegal and no baby should ever be aborted again. And then you have the Planned Parenthood supporters, who are basically pro-choice people, and they say that a woman's body is her own business, and if she wants to get her baby aborted, then that is her thing, no matter what the circumstances. May that be, maybe she got raped and she doesn't want the baby to be an everyday reminder, or maybe she has a health condition and cannot physically take care of the baby. The videos that were released are very hard to watch, and there was a screening held for representatives from both sides of the debate, and investigators, and also reporters. And there was a reporter there by the name of Stephen Ertlett, and he said Democrats literally turned the other way so that they didn't have to watch the gruesome videos. Another reporter, Kelly Harkness, tweeted, "Planned Parenthood employees are staked outside the screening room, but still refuse to talk to the media." In one video, they use a term, a morbid term, saying that they use a less crunchy abortion. And in one video, Cecil Richards, who's the Planned Parenthood president, was recorded saying, "I want to be able to buy a Lamborghini with this money." On the other side of this debate, Planned Parenthood insists that these videos are falsified and even hired a private investigator to prove so. The private investigator said that the videos were fake because the videos were distorted, the timestamps didn't match up, the subtitles didn't match what the people were saying, and Planned Parenthood officials said that the videos were taken out of context. In each video, it basically just showed a Planned Parenthood representative talking to an undercover employee of the CMP, and they were posing as a potential client. And these videos were done in the most casual of settings, including one where the Planned Parenthood representative was drinking wine and giggling. Also, the accusation is that they're selling these for profit. According to 42 U.S. Code 274E, to buy or sell human parts is a federal felony. And 42 U.S. Code 289G2 states trafficking parts of aborted baby fetuses is liable to 10 years in prison or a $500,000 fine. Planned Parenthood is very aware of both of these facts, so if they are doing something illegal, they know very well that they are doing something bad. And now the main question of should abortion be legal or illegal? In many states, abortion is still illegal. And in the states where it is legal, there are pro-life rallies all the time where 100 to even 1,000 more research than it's looking at Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's, Down syndrome, and cystic fibrosis. So it's not just being sold for no reason. So the only thing left is to look at your own morals and decide for yourself, are you pro-life or pro-choice?